Tommy Ryan was the first monthly winner of the 2019 WLR Granville Hotel GAA Award. The Tallow attacker was in impressive scoring form as Waterford made a blistering start to life in Division 1B of the Alliance Hurling League. Tommy netted a brace of goals with two brilliant finishes in Waterford's comfortable win over Laois at O'Moore Park.
I suppose they have, myself and Stephen and Shane, that our general instinct always playing used to be going for goals. Even you see the lads playing for Ballysaggart when they get inside, that their first option sometimes is just to go at the men, and we've got inside a few times, but I suppose the lads have encouraged us as well to kind of go at teams and stuff and not to be afraid to take them on, and they never really give out to us if we're making mistakes inside once we're trying things.
Annie Fitzgerald was the winner in March after the Waterford and Galtier star had a hectic month, playing a pivotal role in the success of St Angela's Ursuline, who became the first Waterford school to lift an All-Ireland A Schools Camogie title. Annie, who was captain and player of the match, hit 1-9 in their replay win over Cross and Passion from Antrim.
It's nice to be recognised. Like, it's good for Camogie as well. But I suppose it is a team sport, and I'm kind of here accepting on behalf of all the teams. Like, there's no way we would have won anything without the 2025 grads are on the panel, so yeah, it's great to be here representing the school and club as well, so yeah, it's good.
You definitely get to a stage where you really do embrace the wins and the good days, and maybe more so than you would have when you're starting out in your career. There's a lot of hard work that goes into it, and I suppose thinking back, we've played in maybe 7 national finals since 2010, and on top of that a Munster senior final, and out of those we only would have had actually 2 victories in, we'll say, the league replay against Tipperary to come up to Division 2, and also the All-Ireland Intermediate Final in 2015. So look, winning a national final wasn't lost on us. It was a very special moment.
Ladies football was to the fore once again in May, with Maria Della Hunty the monthly winner. The Abbey side attacker finished with 1-4 and put in a player of the match display as Waterford were crowned Division 2 National League champions following a 5-13 to 1-17 victory over Kerry.
Team performance, absolutely. Like, I just think everyone played brilliant, and to bring Chloe Fennell on then at half time, like, she was just a bundle of energy then when she came on as well, and everyone played their part today. It was the best I've ever seen us play, honest to God. Yeah, delighted.
June went to Waterford Camogie captain Niamh Rockett, who scored 1-2 from play in a player of the match performance against Dublin at Welsh Park to inspire the Daisha to their first win of the All-Ireland series. Niamh says that the back garden at home was very competitive when she was growing up.
Oh yeah, I remember I was out in the garden with my father, my neighbours, my brother, and sure, we could be like Crow Park out in the garden there some days now, and they'd tear everyone out. They'd tear my little sister out, and she'd be just take the purse, and you mightn't even have a hurley in her hand, like, you know. And I got a bang in the head, and I remember I went down and I was pumping blood, and my father was like, "Get up, there's nothing wrong, Chick. Get up, stitches." I had to get stitches over my eyes. "There's nothing wrong, Chick. Get up, you'll be grand," like, you know. Yeah, there was often times my brother would always go to football and hurling matches every weekend, so yeah, it was very, very competitive. Even I was a bit smaller than my brother, and we used to just eat each other. I suppose that's where I came from.
Bet Carton scored 5 goals and 36 points in 6 matches this summer as the Daisha made it back to the All-Ireland quarterfinals. She picked up the July award and was named player of the tournament as the Grace Dew outfit won the All-Ireland Sevens against local rivals Galtier in Kilmacud Crokes.
Yeah, look, I suppose it was a season definitely of mixed emotions. We definitely, I suppose, you could see the improvement from last year. Started off with the tip game on June the 15th, and look, that was definitely a day of mixed emotions with the abandonment and everything, but we took it game by game, and to get back to a quarter final was massive.
Dual star Desi Hutchinson claimed the August award. He fired 6 points from play as Ballygunnery's Pass Passage in the quarterfinals of the County Senior Hurling Championship. The former Brighton and Hove Albion soccer star and Waterford FC player was surprised to pick up his first monthly award.
Yeah, it was, in fairness. It's probably the last thing I expected, to be honest. I'm only back, I suppose, not long, and to get something like this so early, it's great, but I'm just delighted to be back playing with Galtier and Ballygunner, and we have a big few weeks ahead of us.
Ballymacarbery attacker Sinead Ryan kicked 1-9 in a player of the match performance against Cumber Rangers as Ballymacarbery won their 38th county title in a row. She picked up the award in September, following in the footsteps of her sister Michelle earlier on in the year.
Absolutely, yeah, it is. It's very special to get this award. You know, Michelle was the April winner, yeah, and yeah, I'm absolutely over the moon to get the September one. Oh, absolutely, definitely the hardest. I mean, we were 6 points down at one stage in the match, and you know, like, things were really, you know, going for Cumber Rangers, and I suppose half time just came at the right time. And, you know, we just came out in the second half and we really just dug deep, and thank God we did, and we got over the line.
Ballysagard midfielder Kieran Bennett struck 9 points from play in the Western final win over Ardmore and added 4 in the county final against Ballygunner as they earned promotion to the senior ranks. He was one of our October joint winners, and he admitted that 2019 has been an unbelievable season.
Oh God, definitely. I think this year was the first time we've ever won a Western intermediate. So from then on, everything has just been a bonus. You know, we've been in cloud nine since, kind of. Just a bit of a weight kind of lifted off our shoulders after getting that first Western final, and every game since was kind of played with that bit more freedom, I think. So it's just a big help.
Ratgormack's Conor Murray was the other joint winner in October. He played a major part as Ratgormack won their first county senior football title since 1999 with a hard-fought win over Ballinacorty in Farfield.
The past 5-6 weeks have been incredible, really. The build-up to the county final, seeing the flags up around the village was top to toe and red and green. You've seen that yourself when you came up the day of the county final, a few days after it. It's hard to put into words what it meant to so many people around the village, the lift it gave everyone. And then up to Milltown Malbay a few weeks, 3 weeks after the county final, and again the support was incredible. I think we did outnumber the Milltown supporters in their own home field, 2.5 hours away from the village. So no, it was an invaluable experience, and it's one that's going to stand to us for the next few years, I'm sure.
It was the first award for Conor Sheehan, who in November emerged as a key player for Ballygunner as they continued their impressive form in the Munster Club Championship.
I suppose I've been on the panel. I've been on the panel for a few years, and I think this year is the kind of year that I made a breakthrough. And look, I suppose that's obviously huge thanks to Darragh O'Sullivan and David Franks for putting so much belief in me, I suppose, you know, and allowing me to kind of perform at that stage, you know what I mean? So that was great, I suppose.
And another first-time winner is Owen Kearns, who was awarded the final monthly award in December. He delivered a man-of-the-match performance as St Mary's bridged a 30-year gap to win the county junior hurling title, hitting 8 points in the win over Ballydurn.
That was a special day. That was definitely the proudest day for me, and it'll be hard to beat that feeling when we got over Ballydurn by 2 points. It was a great day, yeah.